guys. I haven't done a video in a long time. And I just did some messing around with my desktop. I haven't really messed around with it in a long time. It was starting to get really cluttered. So I threw everything in a folder and threw it on my second monitor and decided to re-download Rain Meter. I'd used Rain Meter at one point in time and I really liked it, but I don't know. All the skins that I had downloaded for it were kind of, I don't really want to say, like, outdated, but they were, like, the typical kind of, like, riced-out computer, blue neon lights and all that stuff. And I decided to go for something a lot cleaner this time. This is actually a pretty common setup. It's the Rainmeter Skins Origami mixed with Honeycomb for the desktop icons like these. This is its own thing, and this is actually mixed in with my Spotify down here, which is linked to a dock. But there's also, let me just turn down the volume real quick on my Spotify. I guess I can't do that, right? That doesn't make sense because then the equalizer doesn't work, which I don't know, that's one of my favorite parts about this is the equalizer. But that's also tied in with my Spotify. We'll go into that a little bit more. Right now I just kind of want to show you the basics of getting this set up. So you're just going to download Rain Meter. I'll have the links to everything in the description. I'm not going to sit here and pull everything up and show you. A lot of it's on DeviantArt. It's stuff you download from DeviantArt. They're all safe. You can actually go to the Rain Meter's DeviantArt and it'll link top themes and wallpapers and stuff like that. But there, when you download it, there are going to be a couple things you need to change around. For example, this dock comes with, I don't know, it comes with like apps that I don't use. So I kind of had to go through and make my own, which isn't really hard. It's essentially just an 800 by 800 pixel square in Photoshop, and you put the logo of what you want, and then you make a decent background color for it. And the actual script itself for this has masks built in. There you can see the left side masks right there for the first one. That makes it kind of into that diamond shape. Yeah, I had to go through and pretty much make my own icons, which is found in the resources folder if you ever need to make your own as well. A couple other things I had to play around with were obviously the weather. Rainmeter uses the weather.com code found in the very end of the URL. So like for just a basic New York would be, this would be the link, and you're gonna need to cut this out and paste it where it says weather code right here. I obviously had my zip code in there before the video, but that's really not something you should go around telling everyone on the internet, right? So that's pretty simple there. You can change between Celsius and Fahrenheit. You literally just have to copy and paste what you want at the unit area. One other thing I had to change with Origami would probably be, let's see. Yeah, it didn't want to recognize my hard drive, my 1 terabyte hard drive. It was recognizing my SSD just fine, but it actually is preset to disk drive labels. So if yours is not labeled, obviously your main drive is going to be C unless you change that for some reason, but If yours isn't labeled CE or the recovery D drive, then you're gonna have to change it here. That's really not a big issue. Let's see, what else was there? I kind of just want to go over all the things you have to change before I actually get into what everything does. These clocks, some of them are set to military time, the standard world 24-hour clock. If you want that, you can use that code right there, because I am in the U.S. and I'm not on military time. Using I instead of H turns it into the 12-hour cycle for noon and midnight. And then the equalizer I showed you down here. My Spotify is still playing. You can change the color of the bars. All you do is edit this value with the color you want, and it goes by RGB. So obviously, you're going to use the code 255 as the max number. The example here is 255 for the R slot, which is going to make the bars full red. You could make that 0, and then you could make that 255, and it would be green, and that one would be blue if you did that, etc., etc. I honestly just like the white, because everything I use kind of has the white outline or the white background to it. Let's see, what else? So that's really all the playing around I had to do. The Spotify plugin that comes with ClearText here, that's one of the, all these are different plugins. I'll have a link to all of them in the description for you, as well as some wallpapers that I use. I like mountain and forest wallpapers, kind of just like nature wallpapers, and I know a lot of people that do. So I'll throw those in there. But now we'll get to the actual functionality of Origami and Honeycomb. So if you click up here, it's going to open up a bar. Just click on the Origami thing. That'll open and close it. Here you can change to some preset colors for everything. So now everything changes to black. Or you can do blue. I prefer red, though. I don't know why, it just looks good on the white. That's really all I do with this up here. It's just for modifying the color. But let's see, what else? Each one of these widgets has code you can mess with by right clicking and editing the skin. For example, this one right here, this pulls the Spotify plugin that should come with it, and that allows it to connect to your Spotify. Now, one of the weird things that I have noticed is that Spotify has to be open before Rain Meter. Otherwise, this little clear text now playing thing just kind of spazzes out, and it'll sit there saying fetching data. But you can still use the controls, which is really weird. So it still connects to the Spotify, it just doesn't pull the now playing information. And if you click right here, it pulls up a settings menu for it. You can change what text you want. Like, you could change the top text to the artist and the bottom to the album, or switch those around however you want. What minimal mode pretty much does is it makes it so if you're not hovering over it to change any settings, it goes away. Just like that. Obviously, you can switch the color and change the size. A lot of these, if you right click them and go to variants, there's one for music and one for Spotify. The one for Spotify pulls the plugin. The one for music, you can select your player. So if you want to use FUBAR or iTunes or whatever you have on your computer, I have it set up for Spotify, so I'm not sure if there's anything special you have to do for iTunes or FUBAR, but there is the option to go that route. A thing with Honeycomb, these little badges here, they need to be set. I don't really know how to explain what I mean by set. Some of them work just fine. Some of them pull the executable right from here. You don't need to put the full file path in. But for something a little bit more, for example, this one requires the full file path to the Discord executable. Not hard to set up again. You just copy and paste the folder path or the path to the executable into the left mouse up action. There'll be something generic there, except this one's the Discord one's custom made. There was a badge pre-made for it on Reddit, but you kind of have to change around the code a little bit. And by a little bit, I mean put Discord up here, copy and paste the image, and then change the file path. So it didn't take too much work, but a lot of them you do have to change the file path, especially with this doc. The way this doc was initially set up is it just pulled like a default image. Like for instance, this one, it just had app to icon. It's like I don't have this one set up, so if I click it, nothing happens because there's no path inserted for it. However, my CSGO one has the path to the Steam ID for CSGO, and if I clicked it, it would open. Just for example, if I click, well, I already clicked the Spotify one, but if I click the Spotify one, my Spotify opens. Same thing up here. I click the Spotify, my Spotify opens. So there's really a lot of customization you can do to it, and it doesn't clutter your desktop. You can put pretty much links to everything you need in here. Like this one should open up my file explorer, so you can just have one that leads straight to your file explorer. And oh, or maybe not. Huh, that one doesn't want to. Oh, there we go. Whoops. Open three or four of them. So that one will take you straight to the file explorer. You could just do something like that. I use Clover. It's kind of like a internet browser window for your folders. You can open new tabs, close tabs. You can press down on the scroll wheel on stuff and it'll open it up. A lot of this is pretty self-explanatory. I had a lot of issues getting the Spotify thing to work, so I will stress it once more. Spotify does have to be open before Rainmeter does. Generally, Spotify will boot in the startup before Rainmeter. Rainmeter takes about 5 to 6 seconds on an SSD to start up, to launch after startup. And it's really not a big computer hindrance. Right now I'm recording and you can see I'm using 60% of my RAM, which I only have 8 gigs anyways. My computer's honestly not that great, and I'm using 33.62. I'm using like 30% of my CPU. And these are my extremely sad download speeds because I live out in the sticks. But if there's any questions, I can be as helpful as possible in answering them. Once again, this is like all customizable. It doesn't have to look the same as mine. You can find a different Spotify player if you want. You can find a different date and clock and weather thing if you want. There's plenty of cool themes you can go with when it comes to Rain Meter. I'll leave a link to the Rain Meter Deviant Art. Once again, completely safe. If you feel you're downloading something suspicious, check it. There's plenty of website checkers on the internet that'll scan for any malicious files before you download something. I have never once had an issue with Rain Meter, with Rain Meter skins. So, I think that's about it. This is going to be your general application that you're using to enable stuff. Once you have one of the, because there's so many options when it comes to Honeycomb, if you just right click and click on Honeycomb, you can start enabling different ones from this drop down menu. It makes it a lot easier other than going in, clicking Honeycomb, clicking whichever one, and then loading loading, etc., etc. You can save this preset, or save the preset you make. Before you make any changes, Rain Meter should automatically back up. So if for some reason you lose your current setup, whatever you want to call it, it should save something to back up to fairly recently. So not everything's deleted. If you need any of the dock icons made, feel free to let me know. As for the Honeycomb ones, there should be a file somewhere in the resources for a blank template. All you have to do is drag the icon onto it that you want. Make sure it's a transparent. It's just the icon on the little honeycomb, and then just save that. And after every change you make, so for example, I come here, edit the code. Say I just pasted this in. I just pasted the path in. You're going to want Control S for a quick save, or you can come to File and Save. And then you're going to want to close out, right click again, and refresh skin. And then it would pull that new file path that you had just put in there. So there's. I really wish I could show off the equalizer more, but I don't know how loud it's going to be over my voice. So maybe I'll just put something on here really quick and let it play at volume. And that way, like I said, you can easily change the color of the bars if you decide to go for something else. If you decide to go for something else, you can easily change the color of the bars. I didn't mean to slide the volume up there. So I'm just going to let the equalizer play for a couple of seconds, and that'll pretty much be the outro to the video. I don't know if I'll put the actual sound in there of the music playing, but this is the equalizer. Headed for the same disaster, faster and faster and faster. I couldn't stop at the red light, stop at the red light. I couldn't stop at the red light. Your car crashed, and I can't look away. I came along for the ride, you wicked with the clutch. Now, once again, this equalizer, I think is, I before said that I think it's tied to my Spotify, but I think it's actually tied to overall system sounds, because if I'm watching a YouTube stream or YouTube or a Twitch stream or something like that, the equalizer bars still work. So it must be generalized to system sound. But that's pretty much going to be the video. Once again, if you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment. I will help in any way possible if it's a general issue that I've come across. I'm by no means extremely good at troubleshooting Rain Meter or the skins for it. A lot of them are, I don't want to say outdated, but they're like 2 to 3 years old. The creators come out with newer skins, etc., etc. So that could also be an issue. It could just be something that's become outdated if you're not using what I have. Everything I have here is up to date. Everything does work. It may take a little messing around in the code and stuff, but it's pretty much kiddie code. I mean, there's nothing, everything you need to change, I've pretty much pointed out. Let's see, I'm just trying to think if there's anything else. That should pretty much be it. There is a, you can set like an user profile picture here. I obviously haven't. There's really no reason for me to. But that is over where I showed you that I input the new logos for the dock here. There's actually, let me see, let me open this up real quick and drag it over here. I'll just go here real quick. So if you click on the images, there's a folder here called Avatar, and there's instructions literally right on the image that they use. Just drag and drop any file size, any format, PNG, JPEG, whatever. I don't think it would work with a GIF, maybe. I haven't tried it. I haven't messed around with this at all. But that's pretty much it. Thank you for checking out this video. I'm more than happy to help if anyone needs some help getting this stuff installed or set up. And we'll see you next time.